Hello friends, welcome to TechStudyCell. In this video, we will make a very interesting IoT project with LoRa to control appliances where internet is not available from anywhere in the world with the Alexa and Google Assistant. And you can also monitor the real-time feedback in the Google Home and Amazon Alexa app. And for this project, I have used all the free tools. Everything is free, and during the video I have shared the complete circuit source code, so you can easily make this project after watching the complete video. So this is our project. Although for the transmitting and LoRa circuit I have used PCB just to avoid any loose connection, but you can make this circuit without using any PCB. And this is the receiving and LoRa circuit. Now whenever I ask Alexa or Google Assistant to turn on any relay, it sends a signal to Synric, then Synric sends a signal to NodeMCU through internet, then NodeMCU sends a signal to Arduino through the LoRa. After receiving the signal, Arduino processes the signal and accordingly turn on or off the relays and send the feedback to NodeMCU again through the LoRa. Then NodeMCU sends the feedback to Synric through internet, and we can monitor the real-time feedback on Amazon Alexa and Google Home app. And I can also control these appliances from this push button and also from these manual switches connected with the Arduino. So for this project, only the NodeMCU and your smartphone should be connected with the internet, and the distance between the transmitting end and receiving end LoRa circuit can be up to 4 to 5 km in the rural area. So these lamps are not connected with the internet, but still we can control these appliances from anywhere in the world and monitor the real-time feedback in the smartphone. Now before going to the details, let me show you how you can easily design professional PCBs for your any electronics project using the Altium PCB designing software. Altium is a very well-known and most trusted PCB designing software. The user interface is so simple that you can easily design any complex PCB in Altium, and it also provides a lot of useful tools and features for routing, which will save you a lot of time, and you will find a lot of details tutorial which will help you to use this software to make professional PCB very easily. So I will highly recommend you to download the free trial version of the Altium software from video description, and later on if you like this software you can purchase it. Now first let me show you how this project works.
Hey Google,
turn on outdoor light.
Sure, turning the outdoor light on.
You can see the lamp turns on, and I can also monitor the real-time feedback on this OLED. Now let me try Alexa. So now I will just tap on the button to turn on the lights. So you can see the street light turns on and I can monitor the real-time feedback. And I can also use this manual switch to control the lamps, and I have also used EEPROM memory. So if I turn off the complete supply, you can see all the lamp turns off and Arduino has no power supply. Now again if I turn on the supply, the lamps will automatically turn on, fetching the previous state from EEPROM memory. Now I can also use this push button to control these lamps. Let me press the first push button and you can see the first lamp turns off. Now if I press the button again, the lamp turns on, and always I can monitor the real-time feedback on this OLED. This is the transmitter and LoRa circuit. Here I have used NodeMCU, and these two resistors will act as a voltage divider to drop down 5 volt logic level to 3.3 volt for this LoRa module. And for the receiving end circuit, I have used Arduino Uno. You can use any other microcontroller. And again, these two resistors will act as a voltage divider, and you can also use push button instead of the switches. The circuits are very simple. You can easily make it on breadboard or zero PCB. But to make the circuit compact, I have designed a PCB for the transmitting and LoRa circuit. You can also design such PCB easily on Altium. Now before programming the microcontroller, I have to quickly configure the Synric Pro account. So you have to visit this page. I have already an account, so let me log into Synric Pro. After login, I will go to device. In free account, you can add maximum 3 device. To add device, I will click on add device button. Here I have to give a name, say outdoor light. Then I will enter the description. Device type will be switch. Now click on next. And if you want any push notification, then you can configure this, and you can also add timer to that device. Now click on save. Now again I will go to device. Then again I will click on add device to add second device. Here I am giving the name street light, and again device type will be switch. So in this way I will add 3 devices as I am using free account. Now these are the source code of this LoRa project. This is the code for the transmitting end circuit. Here you can see code NodeMCU is written here, and we have to upload this code to Arduino, which is for receiving end LoRa circuit. First let me open the code for the transmitting end, and in this code you have to install these libraries. After that, here you have to mention the Wi-Fi name, then Wi-Fi password. Then to get the app key and app secret, I have to go to the Synric Pro account. Then I will go to credential, and here you will find app key and app secret. So let me copy the app key. I will click on this copy button. Then I will go to the sketch, and here I will paste the app key. Then again I will go to the Synric account. Now I will copy the app secret. Then in the sketch I will paste the app secret. Now here we have to mention the device ID. So again let me go to the Synric account, and now I will go to device. Here I will copy the first device ID. I will just click on this button. Then I will go to sketch, and here I will paste the device ID for the first device. In this way you have to enter the device ID for all the devices. As I am using free Synric account, so I can create only 3 devices. So I can only control the first 3 relay with Google Assistant and Alexa. After that you have to define some parameter for the LoRa communication. First I have defined a band 865 MHz, which is the eligible LoRa band in India. You have to select this band according to your country. Then I have defined a network ID 5. Then I have defined the address 1 for the transmitting end LoRa module. And this LoRa module will communicate with the receiving end having address 2. So after defining all these details, you can directly upload this code to NodeMCU. Now this is the code for the receiving end where I have used Arduino Uno. Now here you don't have to install any library. Now these are the parameters for the receiving end LoRa module. Again I have used the band 865 MHz and network ID 5. And I have defined the address 2 for the receiving end LoRa module, and it will communicate with the LoRa module having address 1. Now I will program this to microcontroller. Now I will quickly configure the Google Home and Amazon Alexa app. Let me open the Google Home app. First I will create a home. So I will tap on this plus icon and select create new home. Here you can give any name to this home. I am giving LoRa control. Then tap on continue. Now here you can give the address. Here I am skipping this step. After that I will again tap on this plus icon and select setup device. Now here I will select works with Google. Then here I will search for Synric Pro. Now tap on this Synric Pro. Tap on continue. Now you have to enter the credential for the Synric Pro account. Now if I go to dashboard, you will find all the 3 devices which we have added in Synric Pro is showing here. Now I will configure the Amazon Alexa app. Let me open the app. Then tap on more and select skills and games. Then here search for Synric Pro. Then tap on the Synric Pro. Then tap on enable to use. Then again you have to log in to your Synric Pro account. Then tap on close. Now tap on discover devices. Now this process may take some time, and here you can see this LED is glowing, which indicate NodeMCU is connected with the Synric server. And here you can see 3 devices found. Now go to device, and under the plug you will get all the devices which you have created in Synric. Now as you can see our circuit is ready. I have connected the appliances with the relay module. Now I will turn on the supply and after that I have to wait till the status LED turns off. Now I can control these appliances from the Google Home app. Let me turn on the outdoor light. You can see the lamp turns on. Now let me control the appliances with Amazon Alexa app. So if I go to device plug, now if I try to turn on the street light, you can see the lamp turns on. And I can also monitor the real-time feedback on the OLED and both Google Home and Amazon Alexa app. So this is a very useful IoT project, and you can control the appliances from anywhere in the world with the combination of IoT and LoRa. So if you like this project, then please hit the thumbs up, and you can also support my work on Patreon. I will really appreciate that. And don't forget to subscribe for more such projects. Thank you for watching. Have a great day.